all so much for joining me from my previous videos. In today's video, I'm continuing with my cycle of reproductive health, and I'm going to talk to you just a minute about vaginal discharge. Yeah, so I've been seeing so many ads on the internet telling ladies, go and steam your vagina, it's good for your vagina. Go and douche, there's so many adverts on douching agents. And ladies, let me just tell you one thing. First, your vagina cleanses itself. Sorry for using that word, so I'll just use the birth canal. It cleanses itself. Then second, douching, steaming, they kill the bacteria, the normal bacteria, because we usually have normal flora, which is normal bacteria that helps you fight infection around that area. So when you're douching, when you're steaming, you're doing more harm than good. So I'd really advise against you doing that. Just clean your bath canal with only water. Just use water to clean it. It's self-cleansing. You don't have to use a lot of medicated soaps, use a lot of steaming. It's not good for your health. And then, okay, let me just get there. So, but my point is home. Yeah, so what is vaginal discharge? So this is just fluid that comes out of your birth canal, and it usually has dead cells and bacteria. That's why I said it's self-cleansing. So it cleanses your system, and it has those dead cells and bacteria are flushed out. Then it's mostly normal, which is a regular occurrence, and it keeps the tissues healthy, your birth canal tissues, and then it helps in lubrication, and then it helps prevent infection and irritation. Yeah, so there are different types of vaginal discharge, so I'll just demonstrate one. It's white. So white, you get a bit of it after menstruation. Immediately after your menses, you'll realize that your discharge is usually white. So white like this area. Yeah, and then it's no, sometimes it's normal, but if it's accompanied by itching, and then it's thick, and then it's cheese like, I don't know if you know how cheese looks like, but yeah, if it looks like that in appearance, you could be having an infection. It now ceases to be normal, now it goes into a yeast infection, candidiasis. That's why you see many ladies usually complain of yeast infections. Yeah, and then the second one, we have clear and watery. So clear and watery, it just looks like that water. Yeah, so it's clear like that and it's watery. So it's normal, and it occurs after heavy exercise and during sexual arousal. Yeah, so if you see clear watery fluid coming out of you, it's normal, nothing to worry about. Then if it's clear and stretchy, so it's clear like this, but it's kind of, how do I explain it, but kind of thick, it's more viscous than the one that I've talked about before. Yeah, so that one is normal, and it occurs during your ovulation. Yeah, and then if you have brown and bloody, so like this color on top here, this color, yeah, so that one is normal, and it happens right after. Okay, it could be normal or abnormal. So if it's normal, it happens right after menstruation. You realize that towards the end of your menses, the color of the blood usually looks like this. So it's nothing to worry about. But if it could be now way after your menses, it could be spotting. And it could be a sign of a pregnancy or a miscarriage. So just out of nowhere, blood like this one comes out of your V. It's either you're pregnant and you're spotting, or it's a miscarriage if you're pregnant, so you can go get checked. And then rarely it could be because of endometrial cancer or cervical cancer. So you can find someone with cervical or endometrial cancer, they produce liquid like that. And then also sex, very painful sex. If you have painful sexual intercourse and then your vaginal area is hurt, you can bleed. Also, I don't know if this is true, if you're losing your virginity, some people may, because of breaking of the hymen, that could be the reason why. Yeah. Then yellow or green. So it could be greenish yellow. So it usually looks like something like this, or like this, this color. Yeah. So that one, since that one is not normal at all, then it's usually thick, chunky, foul smelling. So this means that you have an infection, either trichomonas vaginalis, which is like infection caused by a protozoa, and then sexual intercourse and sexually transmitted infections. So if you've like had sexual contact with someone and then you start producing that, just know you might be having an STI, so you go get checked. So like gonorrhea and chlamydia, they cause that a lot. Then if you have a strong, fishy, foul-smelling discharge, that one is because you have an infection caused by a bacteria. It's called bacterial vaginosis. So you better go get checked. Yeah. So these are some of the diseases that cause that smell. I've said bacterial vaginosis. You have STIs also. Then you have candidiasis. Then pelvic inflammatory disease, HPV or cervical cancer. So these are the diseases that are associated with vaginal discharge. So how do you prevent these different like bad vaginal discharges, like the yellow green, the thick card like that looks like candidiasis? Yeah, so hygiene, make sure you shower. Don't use soap, just shower with water only. I'll stress on that. Then we have breathable cotton underwear. Yeah, so make sure it allows you to breathe. And then at night, I'd advise that you sleep commando. Even sometimes just go commando. You don't have to wear panty all the time. Please, just breathe. And then don't douche. Yeah, don't douche. Don't do vaginal steaming, because they use so many aromatic smells. They lie to you that your vagina will smell well because of a man that you're going to like have sexual intercourse with. Please, just let it smell normally. It's supposed to be like that. Don't interfere with nature. And then practice safe sex. Make sure you use a condom. And then take yogurt regularly, because it's a probiotic. So it's good for, it has bacteria, lactobacilli, that are good for your vaginal area. And then something also to do with douching, it also increases the risk of infection because it changes the pH around your area. So how do you treat that? You can use antifungals in case of candidiasis. So people are usually given pessaries, the V1, V2, V3, yeah, such like things. And then you can use antibiotics, and then there are usually kits that combine antibiotics and antifungals and antiprotozoa to help you clear that. Yeah, so I think that's it. If you have any questions or any issues with your vaginal discharge, please let me know. I'll be able to explain that to you. So thank you so much. In case of anything, reach out, and yeah, let's continue sharing so that other people may also gain. Bye.